Hi, this is an impatient tutorial. This is how you do a double drop shadow. I'm starting off with just a text layer and a background color. I'm going to duplicate the text layer, and I'm going to hide that third one. We'll call that layer C. We're going to move on to layer B. Go into your adjustments, do a motion blur, and pull it out just a little bit, not too far, at an angle. Now I'm going to select my layer B by holding down two fingers on the layers panel, make a new layer, and hide the original text layer. I'm going to use a hard airbrush, and I'm going to color in using whatever color I wanted to make that first drop shadow. Color back over it, just to fill in any transparent spots. And now it's time to go zoom into a part that has a lot of little lines, so you can line up your shadow, make sure it goes exactly where you want it. And I'm going to just adjust it by tapping outside the bounding box to nudge my selection. I'm going to go back to layer C, unhide it, going to do another motion blur, this time in a different direction and a lot longer. When you're doing a motion blur, you want to make sure you do not touch the outer bounds of your canvas, or else it'll clip. I'm going to select my layer C again with a double finger hold, make a new layer, hide layer C, this whole process again, choose a new color, use a hard airbrush, and scribble over my selection. You can't use fill layer on this because it'll preserve that transparent part, but with the brush, just like that, you can fill in those transparent parts. Just go right back ahead and set the blend mode on this to multiply, and 20 is too much. I'm going to change it to 15. And come back down, except this part, when I match up the shadow, I'm going to want to match it up to the bottom of the orange part. In this case, not the yellow part, because the shadow is coming off of the ground. And line that up. Deselect, snap back out, and that's it. Double drop shadow. Done.